Hey everybody, welcome back to the channel. Hope you guys are having a great Friday. Thankfully, we've made it to the weekend. And you know what? Before we get started with the video, if you like the content, if you like the channel, please subscribe. We're getting very, very close to 6K. And that honestly would be an amazing thing to happen to see the channel continue to grow and you guys enjoy the content. So it's appreciated. But let's get on down to the rumor mill that happened last night about Square Enix possibly being purchased, which would have been absolutely insane. Now, Square Enix shoots down acquisition rumors after report boosts its stock. So this actually happened last night, I'd say around the same time as we were recording Press Start Podcast, and we did break the news there. Now, one of the big reasons I like doing my content for the very next day is because I don't want to run out and have to do a follow-up video on stuff that happens the prior day. So this is actually kind of nice to actually have the full scope of information before we went out and do clickbait videos. But hey, let's talk about what's going on, shall we? Square Enix has responded to a report about it potentially looking for a buyer. Now, this morning, a report from Bloomberg Japan revealed that a number of buyers have expressed interest in acquiring Japanese giant Square Enix. Yeah, so we saw that last night and we talked about it. Now, the thing is, these kinds of things happen all the time in business. Mergers and acquisitions, those kinds of conversations happen whether we're knowing of them or not. The thing is, when we find out about them is when it's obviously far too late and things are going on quite well in that discussion. So I wouldn't be surprised if this kind of conversation wasn't used to have people actually bump up Square Enix stock and for them to make a lot of return on those investments. But let's continue on and see what else is going on. Now, the brief report cites an unnamed source in banking who couldn't say whether buyers were only interested in Square Enix's games, business, or the company as a whole. The news was fairly surprising, and it was enough to boost the company's stock price by 13.8% at the Tokyo Stock Exchange by noon. Yeah, like I said before, a lot of people were trying to just boost the stock more than likely by having these kinds of conversations. Now, that is sort of what we would consider market manipulation. Of course, someone in the banking sphere would also try to have that done, but let's continue. In an unusual move, Square Enix actually responded to the report, denying Bloomberg's report outright. In a statement PDF via Dr. Serkan Toto, published this afternoon, the Final Fantasy publisher said it is neither looking to sell nor has it received offers from third parties. Bloomberg has reported stated that there is interest from several buyers to acquire Square Enix. However, this report is not based on any announcement by Square Enix Holdings Co. Ltd., the statement reads. We do not consider selling off the company or any part of its business, nor have we received any offer from any third party to acquire the company or any part of its businesses. I mean, that pretty much solidifies everything right there. It sounds like they're not going to go through it. However, though, that may not mean that these conversations may not be happening again in the background. They may have said no directly, and that probably did hurt their stock price. And of course, the banking insider probably went ahead with market manipulation and made quite a bit of money off of that little statement from Bloomberg. With that being said, though, this does cause some bit of concern. As a previous video that I made when Bethesda was actually purchased by Microsoft, ZeniMax was bought by Microsoft in that acquisition for $7 billion, I actually talked about a potential oligopoly in gaming and how that could actually be a detriment to a lot of people. Granted, it could save a lot of studios from closing down in the long run, but what's been going on is just having just a few giant corporations owning majority of the actual market is in fact a bad thing because it does strangle out a lot of competition that's available for people to go ahead, create startups, create new development studios or houses, or even new publishers, which would also cause a big factor because then you would splinter off the entire market and then you would divvy it up like a couple of mob bosses would. And in turn, that would actually choke out any form of competition. You'd really only have a few players in the actual business, which would never be a good thing because once those players go out or they decide to actually shutter everything down, we would lose everything as gamers and as an art form in video games. But let's see what else we have to say here. Square Enix is working on a number of anticipated high-profile games. There's 7 Remake Integrate. Yeah. Let's look at some comments. And there are none. Wow, that's really a weird thing. There are no comments in this actual article. I would expect there to be quite a few. Anyways, but look, this whole thing is really kind of crazy. What we're looking at is the potentiality of a lot of publishers and a lot of companies getting bought out by people with much bigger pockets. One of the things that I talked about the other day, or a meme that I made on my Twitter account, was that Microsoft would then buy out Square Enix. Now, of course, this isn't true at all, but it would be funny to see. Having Microsoft own that company would actually really give them a good strong foothold and a much more diverse portfolio than what we normally have seen them right now. Now, Japan is one of the biggest markets and they have not impacted yet, and that would be a good way for having them to get some stranglehold and some foothold in that area. With that being said, though, it's not the best way of going about things. In fact, this kind of market push and this kind of purchasing power would be considered predatory in the business world, and that is because they are using their monetary value in order to buy out much of the actual market instead of actually competing. Now, we've heard this before with other storefronts doing the same thing, but hey, I don't want to get into all that right now. With that being said, though, a lot of people wanted Sony to buy Square Enix, mostly because of the long-term history that Square does have with Sony from Final Fantasy VII and the PS1. And I could see that as well. That wouldn't be a bad decision, but Square does own quite a few more things than just video games. There is an anime division and some other things as well. But let me know what you guys think in the comments section down below. Who would you have wanted to see buy Square Enix? What would you guys have liked to actually have happen? Are you glad that Square Enix is not being bought? Like myself, I'm actually very happy Square Enix remains to be independent. But I'd love to hear what you guys think, and it's always a cool thing to have feedback. As well, you can check me out on Twitch and Twitter. It's at Oh No, It's Alex. And like I said before in the beginning of the video, if you like the content, please subscribe. We are on our way to 6K. Thank you so much for watching. I appreciate everything. Hope you guys have a great one, and I'll see you next time. Fucking bullshit. Son of a bitch. Bullshit, Don Gogan.